Sea levels rising rapidly. The Arctic is melting faster than expected and could easily contribute 2 to 3 feet more in global sea levels by 2100 or earlier. Experts state in a report being presented to international officials. The report shatters predictions made 4 years ago by the authoritative United Nations Climate Change Panel. The observed changes in sea ice on the Arctic Ocean and the mass of the Greenland ice sheet and Arctic ice caps and glaciers over the past 10 years are dramatic and represent an obvious departure from the long-term patterns. The International Arctic Monitoring and Assessment Program says in its report. The report compiles the latest science on how climate change has impacted the Arctic in the past 6 years. Melting Arctic glaciers and ice caps are projected to help raise global sea levels by at least 35 to 63 inches by 2100, the program's scientists stated. While the program noted the estimate was highly uncertain, the range was a sharp jump from a 2007 projection of 7 to 23 inches by the United Nations Scientific Panel on Climate Change. Those numbers did not include a possible acceleration of a thaw in polar regions. A leading ice specialist, Richard Alley of Pennsylvania State University, who did not take part in the assessment, agreed that recent scientific estimates generally support a central finding. A sea level rise of more than 3 feet this century fits well within these estimates, and a somewhat higher value cannot be excluded, Alley said. Such a rise above most past scientific estimates would add to threats to coasts from Bangladesh to Florida, low-lying Pacific islands, and cities from London to Shanghai. It would also, for instance, raise costs of building tsunami barriers in Japan. A summary of the key findings shows Arctic temperatures during that period were the highest since measurements began in 1880. The past 6 years have been the warmest period ever recorded in the Arctic, the report stated. The program is backed by the United States and 7 other nations that make up the Arctic Council. In the future, global sea level is projected to rise by at least 0.9 meters, 35 inches, to 1.6 meters, 63 inches, by 2100 or before, and the loss of ice from Arctic glaciers, ice caps, and the Greenland ice sheet will make a substantial contribution, it said. The rises were projected from 1990 levels. Arctic glaciers, ice caps, and the Greenland ice sheet contributed over 40% of the global sea level rise of approximately 3 millimeters per year observed between 2003 and 2008, it said. The report was to be unveiled at a meeting of the Arctic Council officials with foreign ministers from Arctic Council nations, United States, Russia, Canada, Sweden, Finland, Denmark, Norway, and Iceland. UN talks on a global pact to combat climate change are making slow progress. The United Nations says national promises to limit greenhouse gas emissions, mainly from burning fossil fuels, are insufficient to avoid dangerous changes. The new report, drawing on work by hundreds of experts, said there were signs that warming was accelerating. In other words, these could be conservative estimates. The increase in annual average temperature since 1980 has been twice as high over the Arctic as it has been over the rest of the world, the report said. Temperatures were higher than at any time in the past 2,000 years, it added. As a result, the Arctic Ocean could be nearly ice-free in summers within 30 to 40 years, earlier than projected by the UN Climate Panel, it stated. As reflective ice and snow shrink, they expose ever bigger areas of darker water or soil. Those dark regions soak up ever more heat from the sun, in turn, stoking a melt of the remaining ice and snow. There is evidence that two components of the Arctic cryosphere, snow and sea ice, are interacting with the climate system to accelerate warming, the report also stated. In conclusion, it's very possible that sea levels could rise much faster been earlier expected or predicted and could affect worldwide weather patterns with unknown consequences and could affect many coastal cities and areas all around the world. This too is another sign of the times, the end times, transition days, which is a continuing day-by-day process of extraordinary happenings, changes, and events. All things or systems that must change rapidly or quickly and for the better, because it's about what kind of world are we leaving to the future generations. Revelation chapter 16, verse 12, and the sixth angel poured out his vial upon the great river Euphrates, and the water thereof was dried up, that the way of the kings of the east might be prepared. 13, and I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. 14, for they are the spirits of devils, working miracles, which go forth unto the kings of the earth and of the whole world to gather them to the battle of that great day of God Almighty. 15, behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that watches and keeps his garments, lest he walk naked, and they see his shame. 16, and he gathered them together into a place called in the Hebrew tongue Armageddon. 17, and the seventh angel poured out his vial into the air, and there came a great voice out of the temple of heaven from the throne, saying, It is done. 18, and there were voices and thunders and lightnings, and there was a great earthquake, such as was not since men were upon the earth, so mighty an earthquake, and so great. 19, and the great city was divided into three parts, and the cities of the nations fell, and great Babylon came in remembrance before God, to give unto her the cup of the wine of the fierceness of his wrath. 20, and every nation fled away, and the mountains were not found. 21, and there fell upon humans a great hail out of heaven, every stone about the weight of a talent, and men blasphemed God because of the plague of the hail, for the plague thereof was exceedingly great. The time for all prophecy to be fulfilled is now here. The tipping points are all being reached rapidly. Everything is connected, and everything is numbered. And this is what I see, feel, and think.